Michigan-based Christian militia group have been charged in connection with an alleged plot to spark a war against the federal government. A witness to an FBI raid in Indiana said he saw law enforcement officers seize a cache of weapons.
Oh, they had full tactical gear. They had the shields, helmets, bulletproof vests, assault rifles, everything, the whole nine yards, just like you see on TV.
Prosecutors say Hootery members have trained in weaponry and bomb making since at least 2008. Video posted on YouTube shows armed Hootery members conducting military-like training exercises. The individuals in the videos are dressed in full combat gear and carry weapons. In one video, they burn the flag of the United Nations before hoisting their own flag in its place. Part of the group's website reads, quote, "Jesus wanted us to be ready to defend ourselves using the sword."
Well, earlier this month, the Southern Poverty Law Center released a report called Rage on the Right, The Year in Hate and Extremism. It tracks a major rise in domestic right-wing extremist groups in the United States. According to the report, the number of right-wing militias tripled last year to 127. Two chapters of the Hootery Militia, one in Michigan, the other in Utah, were included on the list. Mark Potok is director of the Intelligence Project at the Southern Poverty Law Center in Montgomery, Alabama, and that's where he joins us. Welcome to Democracy Now, Mark. What do you know about this group?
Well, thanks for having me. You know, what we knew very little. We spotted them early in 2009. They seemed to be a very small group, two very small chapters. And what was remarkable about the group was their very particular kind of Christian millennial spin on what are really very common theories in the militia movement. I mean, basically, virtually all militias, the secular militias, have an idea about what is going on out there and the nefarious role that the federal government is playing. What they basically believe is that the government is planning to impose martial law, herd Americans who resist into concentration camps, and ultimately the government will be subsumed in some kind of new world order, a sort of socialist hell is the way it is imagined. You know, this particular group had this very strange spin on the whole theory in which the enemy was not so much a secular new world order as the Antichrist. And they identify the Antichrist very closely with the UN and in particular with Javier Solana. So they're very similar to the other militias we've seen come roaring back in the last year or so, although they have this very particular twist.
And what the FBI, how the FBI found out information about them?
No, I mean, I don't think there's any particular meaning that they're in those states. I will say that Michigan has been quite a hotbed for the militias. Of course, I'm sure many people remember that Timothy McVeigh and Terry Nichols, the Oklahoma City bombers, had contacts with militias in Michigan. So that is, you know, a state where this movement has been roiling and boiling all the way since the 1990s. And it's clear from reading the indictment and some of the supporting affidavits that they had someone in that group, some kind of confidential informant, going back to 2008.
And Mark Potok, let's take this back a little bit before this, the DOJ made this announcement this week regarding the Hootery Militia. There have been a number of incidents over the previous weeks, and lawmakers are continuing to receive threats in the wake of the health care vote. New York Democratic Congressman Anthony Weiner was forced to close an office in Queens Thursday after his staff received a threatening letter with a suspicious white powder. The letter directly referred to Weiner's support for health care reform. At least 10 House Democrats have reported death threats or incidents of harassment since last week. As Congress was preparing to vote for the health care reconciliation package last week, Republican Congressman Steve King of Iowa addressed a group of Tea Partiers and urged opponents of health care reform to beat the other side